So in today's lecture, in the last lecture, we have started discussion on exponential smoothing method. And we have discussed one problem on exponential smoothing method. And previous to that, we have also discussed what is the methodology to solve the exponential to evaluate the forecasting by using the exponential smoothing method. Okay, so that theory part and one problem for the understanding purpose we have discussed in the last lecture. Okay, so in the today's lecture we will discuss two more problem that will be the variety of problems on the exponential smoothing method. Okay, so this is the problem we have discussed in the last lecture. Okay, and here the September month and October month for actual demand is provided, and for the September month I think the forecasted demand is provided. Okay, September and October month actual demand, and for the September month forecasted demand is provided, and we have to determine the forecasted demand for the November month. Okay, so for that case we have considered the given data in this format, and then we have applied our exponential smoothing formula, that is nothing but f of t is equal to f of t minus 1 inside the bracket 1 minus alpha bracket complete plus alpha inside the bracket d suffix t minus 1, where f of t is nothing but the given period or the next period forecasted demand, whereas f of t minus 1 is the current period, or we can say that the current month or the last period or the last month forecasted demand. Alpha is the smoothing constant, and d suffix t minus 1 is the actual demand for the current month or current period or the last month or the last period. Okay, so d suffix t minus 1 is the actual demand. Okay, and by applying this formula we have solved the problem in the last lecture. Okay, so same formula application in the large scale we are going to discuss in the in two different problems. Okay, so the problem number 2, write down the statement for the problem number 2. Data about primary production of electricity. Data about primary production of electricity. Data about primary production of electricity in terajoules. It's a unit of energy, terajoule. Okay, joule and terajoule. So in bracket its symbol is capital T capital J, terajoule. In Slovakia, I think one of the state in America, Slovakia. In Slovakia over the years, over the years 2001 to 2009, over the years 2001 to 2009 is given below. We want to forecast primary production of electricity. We want to forecast primary production of electricity. Primary production of electricity in Slovakia for the year 2010 by using simple exponential method. Take alpha is equal to 0.29. Alpha is equal to 0.29 and 0.26 and 0.26. Determine which forecast is better? Determine which forecast is better. Determine which forecast is better. Okay. And the data provided to you is in a years and observed values. Okay. So observed values, that will be the actual demand. Okay. Actual or actual production. So year 2001. So you can make two rows. One is for year and the second one row is for observed values. Okay. So first year is 2001. And observed value for the production of electricity in Slovakia in terajoule. Okay. It is equal to 17,496. 17,496. For the second year, that is 2002, it is 18,965. 18,965. Then in 2003, it is 12,535. In 2003, it is 12,535. Then in 2004, it is 14,781. In 2004, it is 14,781. Okay. In 2005, it is 16,722. 16,722. Then in 2006, 15,858. 2006, 15,858. Then 2007, 16,053. Okay, 16,053. Then 2008, 14,565. 14,565. And in 2009, it becomes 15,743. 15,747. 15,747. Okay. Okay, I have written all the data. Now we will discuss about what is the problem. Okay, so one of the state in the America and the energy production or the electricity production in that particular state is provided to you from the year 2001 to 2009. Okay, and it is in a terajoule. Okay, so it is asked to you that you have to determine the energy production, or you have to determine the forecasted production for the energy in the year of 2010 for Slovakia state. Okay, and for that purpose we have two options, or in the problem it is provided double smoothing constant, that is nothing but one is 0.29, alpha is equal to 0.29, and second one is 0.26. okay, so the problem having two outcomes. Okay, so first outcome is nothing but we have to determine the energy production, forecasting energy production or electricity production for the year of 2010, and second outcome is we have to compare which one is the better one. Okay, which alpha value is the best suited value for this particular data. Okay, that is the second outcome from this particular problem. Okay, so we try to determine the forecasted demand for the year of 2010 for both the alpha values. Okay, so we can say that now here, what is the main important thing to solve the problem to solve the exponential smoothing method? Okay, now here observed values are provided. Okay, observed values are provided, but the smoothing for exponential smoothing method, we required the actual demand as well as forecasted demand, for the last period. Okay, so that we can determine the forecasted demand for the next month or for the next month, okay, for the next period, okay. So here, but here in this particular whole given data, the forecasted demand is not provided to you, okay. The forecasted demand is not provided to you. So what to do in that particular case? So you have to assume the forecasted demand for the first period, okay, or the first year, it is equal to the observed value, okay. So I will write the solution. The first important note point in this particular problem is forecasted demand. You can also write demand is not provided. So consider actual demand for year 2001 equals to forecasted demand. Okay, forecasted demand. Okay, so what we have considered for the year 2001, jo bhi actual demand hai, utna hi forecasted demand hum 2001 year ke liye consider kar rahe hai. Okay, whenever there is a problem where the data is provided to you in an actual demand, but the forecasted demand is not provided, then for the initial period, you have to consider the actual demand equal to forecasted demand. For the initial period, you have to consider the actual demand for the actual demand equal to forecasted demand. Okay, for which type of problem? For exponential smoothing methodology type of problems. Okay, so then we can use our formula for the exponential smoothing method. That is nothing but this one, f of t is equal to, I will copy directly, okay, f of t is equal to f of t minus 1 inside the bracket. So use f of t is equal to f of t minus 1 inside the bracket 1 minus alpha plus alpha multiplied by d suffix t minus 1. Okay, so this is the general formula that we required for the calculation purpose in exponential smoothing methodology. Okay, so then you have to form the table. Okay, you have to form the table in this manner. The columns of a table should be period, observed value, okay, forecast, and the error. Okay, this error is required at the last to compare which forecast is better. Okay, for that comparison purpose, we required the error. Okay, so that first of all, do the one table or draw one table, and rows of that particular table should be period, observed value, forecast. Okay, now here consider 0.26. Forecast when alpha is equal to 0.26. Okay, alpha is equal to 0.26. Then error, and inside the bracket, error means what? So error in a forecasting methodology, the error is nothing but the variation of forecast from the actual demand. Okay, from the actual demand. Okay, so that is nothing but error. So jo bhi actual mein hai और हमने जो फोरकास्ट किया है, इन दोनों का डिफरेंस जो रहेगा वो एरर रहेगा. ओके, एंड फोरकास्टिंग शुड बी इन अ सच मैनर दैट द एरर शुड बी मिनिमाइज्ड. ओके, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट जो फोरकास्ट किया है और जो एक्चुअल में है, उन दोनों का डिफरेंस मिनिमम रहना चाहिए. वो सबसे अच्छी मेथोडोलॉजी होती है. ओके, जिसमें हमें ये एरर मिनिमम मिल जाएगा, वो सबसे अच्छी मेथोडोलॉजी होती है और वो कंडीशन सबसे अच्छी होती है डाटा के लिए. ओके, सो हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डू दिस टेबल एंड पुट अप द पीरियड फ्रॉम 2008 टू 2010. आई विल टेक इट इन डिफरेंट. ओके, 2010. ओके, बट डाटा फॉर द 2010 इज नॉट अपलोड, सो आई विल टेक इट बिलो सो दैट वी विल सी द कंप्लीट डाटा. ओके, सो period, you can write it 2001 to 2008 10. We have to predict 2010 data that we have to determine from this particular problem. But the data up to 2010 is available. So put up first of all that all the values. Okay. Now, what is the trick in this problem? Okay. First of all, we have to consider whatever the actual demand for the first period or first year, that is equal to forecasted demand. Okay. Actual demand equal to forecasted demand for the first period. Okay. So what is the actual demand for the year 2001? It is equal to 17,496. Same forecasted demand you have to consider if it is not provided. So in this problem, it is not provided. So we are going to consider 17,496. Okay. Now we have the forecasted demand for the year of 2001. We have the actual demand for the year of 2001 so that we can determine the forecasted demand for the year of 2002. As we know that to determine the next period forecasted demand, we required previous year data. Okay. Which data we required? One is nothing but previous year or previous period forecasted demand. And second one is nothing but previous year or previous period actual demand. Okay. So you just do the calculation. So our formula is, we know this formula. Okay, f of t. Once again, I will write over here. Okay, so f of t is equal to f of t minus 1 minus alpha plus alpha inside the bracket t suffix t minus 1. So for the 2001 year, okay, let us say for the 2001 year, we know the data. So we want to determine now for the 2002. Okay, or I will make it 02. Okay. That is nothing but 2002. We will consider that. Then here, what is f of t minus 1? F of t minus 1 that we have considered for 2001 year. Okay. F of t minus 1. So 17,496. Okay. 17,496. Okay. Multiply by. Okay, multiply by. So alpha value that for the initial calculation, we are going to consider as 0.26. So write down 0.26, 1 minus alpha. Here also 0.26. Okay. And okay, sorry. This is the formula. So here I need to write 0.26 and here also 0.26 multiply by d suffix t minus 1. Wo kya hai? Actual demand of a previous period. So actual demand and forecasted demand for the year of 2001 is equal to 17,496. Okay, 496. Okay, so and we will get. Okay, we will get the forecasted demand for the year of 2002. Okay, do calculation and let me know the forecasted demand for the year of 2002. Okay, f of 2002. Okay, that is forecasted demand for the period of or the year 2002. Do calculation everyone and let me know. Calculations are more important. Okay. So write down that 17,495.74, right? Or 54. How much you get it? Okay, 74, right. 74. Okay. So this is the first. So write down this value in the table. Okay. 17,495.74. Okay. Now we know the actual demand and forecasted demand for the year of 2002. Okay. Actual demand and forecasted demand for the 2002. So we can determine the forecasted demand for the year of 2003. Okay, once again consider this formula for the calculation purpose. F of t is equal to, now here my year is f of 03. Okay, that is 2003. Okay, I will write here f of 0.3. Okay, and my forecasted demand for the year is 17495.74. Okay, and multiply by 1 minus 0.26 plus 0.26, and actual demand for the year of 2002 is 18965. Okay, 18965. Okay, now do calculation and find out the forecasted demand for the year of 2003. Fast, everyone, do calculation. Let me know your answer for 2003 year. Okay, 17877.48. Kindly check F of 03 you have calculated. What is F of 04? Let me know the values. Now you understood how to calculate for the further things. That is forecasted demand for the year of 2004. So same calculations you have to repeat for the next years. Okay. Let me know your values. 04, okay, 16488.17, okay, 16488.17, okay. Others, kindly check. Then for the year of 2005, what is the value? Do calculation, everyone. 16044.04. Okay, 16044.04. Okay, then 2006 year. Go with the same concept that for next year or the next period, if you want to do the calculation, then you should have the previous year forecasted demand and the actual demand. Okay, actual demand. So for 2006 year, F of t minus 1, that will be equal to 16044.04, and whereas d suffix t minus 1 is nothing but 16,722. So for 2006 year, 16,220.04. 16,220.04. Then for 2007 year, do calculation. Formula in front of you. Use this formula for the previous data. Okay. For the next period calculation of forecasted demand by using the previous data. Okay. All the values are in front of you. Alpha is 0.26. F of t minus 1, we have to consider the previous period forecasted demand. And d of t minus 1, we have to consider the previous period actual demand. Okay. For 2007 year, what will be the value? Forecasted demand. Others also do calculation. Only ASR is doing this things. Okay. So that will be the good practice for everyone, because okay, 16,125.64. Okay. So this will be the forecasted demand for the year of 2007. Similarly, determine for the 2008 year. And let me know your value in the chat box for 2008 year. Let me note 2008 16106.49. Okay, then calculate for 2009 also. Let me know 2009 year. 15,705.44. Okay, and now you can able to determine the forecasted demand for the year of 2010, that is the one outcome from this particular problem. Okay, now it is able to determine that 2010 year forecasted demand. Okay, as we have last year's actual demand and we have the last year forecasted demand. So now it will be easy to determine the 2010 year. Okay, do calculation everyone, and let me know. After getting your answer only, I will move ahead. Okay. So write down the things also side by side. Don't sit idly. Okay. That will be the waste of time. So, and your internet connection also. Okay. So knowledge gaining is the most important part, and it is one kind of attitude building. So don't forget that nothing is waste in the life. Everything pays off at the right time. Okay. And it will make you losses also in the life if you miss the things, and will not showcase your sincerity towards your actual work. Okay. So both the things are possible. Okay. And at the end, the decision is yours. And like karma, that what you are doing, it will be pays off in this life only. Okay. It will be back to you. So if you are sincere, then life will take you seriously. Okay. If you are negligible, then life also neglect you. So this is the concept, reality concept. 15,715 point. This is the forecasted demand for the year of 2010. So I will make it bold. Okay. Okay. So I will make it bold as this is our answer with the forecast value or the alpha value of 0.26. Next, we have to calculate the errors for particular periods. Okay. Error for the particular period. Now, for this case, for 2001 year, the difference between observed value and the forecasted demand is zero. So we can write here zero. Now, for the 2. So you need to write all the errors first of all. Write down the errors, all the errors. Okay, and let me know your values also. Okay, for first 1469.26. Okay, 1469.26. Okay, next. Okay, next is how much? -5,342. Okay. -5,342.48. Okay, next. What you are thinking from last half an hour, we are solving one problem only. Okay. And that is your response. Okay. I'm not doing anything, but I need involvement to go further. Okay. Next is -1,707.7. What is the next value for the error? Next. Right. -362.04, right? 362, okay, here. 362.04. Next. -72.65. Great. Next. Okay, so make the addition of all the error, but that addition should be a mod of that particular error. So that is nothing but we have to consider the pure numbers and we are taking the average error. That is nothing but divide by total number of errors. Okay, divide by total number of error, that will be considered as a average error or the mean value of a error. Okay, mean value of a error. Do calculation and let me know. What is the value for the average error or 1 divided by n summation of mod of e? Okay, 1 divided by n summation of mod of e. So it is equal to 11,215.16. So I think it is addition. Okay, so Dhanashree, this is the addition of all the errors. Okay, that is nothing but mod of e. We have to divide this by total number of errors. Okay, we have to divide by this value with the total number of errors. So total number of errors are 12. Total number of errors are 9. So we have to divide this addition with 9. Now you are getting 1246.12 or 06. Kindly check 246.06 or 0.12. Okay, whatever it is. Okay, so we are getting the forecasted demand for the year of 2010 and the average error or the mean value of error in this particular calculation with alpha 0.26. okay, similarly you have to perform the calculation for alpha 0.29. okay, and you have to calculate all the errors, you have to calculate the forecasted demand for 2010. Okay, and you have to calculate the errors. Okay, now you better understand the things, now you can perform the calculations for 2010. For alpha is equal to 0.29. okay, alpha is equal to 0.29. initially forecast for the period 2001 is not known to you, so the actual value will be considered as a forecasted demand for that particular initial period. 17,496. Okay, this is the value. Then calculate for 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, and then finally 2010. Then calculate all the errors and write down the average or the mean value of error. That is nothing but mod of e, summation of mod of e, divided by n. Okay, summation of mod of e divided by n. Okay, so do calculation everyone and let me know the answers. Okay, I will should put up my answers over here. You can cross check these answers afterward. Okay, so I will put up my answers. So 2002, my value is the similar one for 17,496. Then for 2003, it is 17,922.01. Then for 2004, it is 16,359. Then for 2005, it is equal to 15,901.93. Then for 2006, You check the values, okay? Everyone do the calculation. I'm giving my values. You perform your calculations. 16,056.58 for 2008 year. And 2009 year, $15,624.02, and the last, that is the our answer for 2010 forecasting with the alpha 0.29 is 15,659.69. Okay. Now further, we have to calculate the errors. Okay, for first year it is zero. Okay, no issue. For the second year, 2002, it is 1469. Okay. Then for 2003, -5,387.01. For 2004, -1,578.78. Then for 2005, 820.07. Then for 2006, 281. Okay, sorry, -281. Then for 2007, -5.04. Then for 2008, -1,491. Then for 2009, it is +122.98. Okay, then we have to do the addition of or mod of addition or mod of summation of all the errors. Mod of summation means mod means we have to neglect the negative signs and we have to consider the values only. Okay, so then average of all the error, it is equal to my values 1000. 239.58 579. Okay, so this is my value. Now, now what is the actual thing? What answers we have to consider? Okay, our answer should be in a such a manner that answer for question. Okay, which forecasted demand you need to consider? Okay, so forecasted for 0.29 we have to consider, or forecasted for 0.alpha is equal to 0.26 that we need to consider. So that answer you will get from this average value of error, or we can say that summation, mod of summation of error divided by n. Okay, so compare this average value of error. Okay, for case of a 0.26 it is 1246.12, and for case of 0.29 it is 1239. Okay, so after comparing we come to know that the error, average value of error in case of a 0.29 is smaller. Okay, error should be smaller. Okay, so that we can say that 1246 and right now 1239, right? So 0.29, so alpha is equal to 0.29, in that case we are getting the less error. So the value of this, or we can say that the forecast with alpha 0.29 is better forecasting as compared to alpha 0.26 forecasting. Okay, and our forecasted demand for the 2010 year with alpha 0.29, that will be the your final answer for the forecasting of the year 2010, that is nothing but 15,659.69. Okay, getting everyone how to solve the problem. Okay, I want to cover all the two problems in this particular lecture, but the response is very poor from your side. There is no meaning for the lectures if I'm doing all the things, I'm solving the problems, I'm writing everything, and you are not doing anything. Okay, so that will be the work for a teacher, not for a student. I have done all these things in my engineering lab. No need to do once again. Okay, so your time, you have to perform the things. Okay, and if you perform well, you will get the result as early as possible. Okay, if you are neglecting the things, the life will neglect you. Okay, and the success will neglect you. Okay, everything is possible. So, and whenever you realize these things, that we have neglected a lot of things in the academics, the time will over for you, and you need to provide extra 1-2 hours to furnish the knowledge of engineering. Okay, so the 2 hours equal to near about, if you say the 5 lakh package for per year, then it will be equal to 10 lakhs. So that will be the loss for you if you neglect the things, and you will not be sincere with your academics. Okay, so thank you so much. We'll stop here for the today, and just put up your roll numbers in the chat box and you can leave this meeting. Okay, and join the next lecture immediately. So today we are having the another one lecture at I think 2 p.m. or 1 p.m. We'll conduct the next problem. We'll discuss the next problem, next variety on this exponential smoothing method, the next lecture.